Hey guys, how's it going? Time for round three of the Horizon IndyCar Winter Series on iRacing. We are racing at Sebring this week. A very strange track for IndyCars, I have to say. Well, at least the full circuit. You know, a lot of the spring testing gets underway, you know, over on the club circuit. But this part we're on now used to be an airstrip. It's made out of concrete. It's extremely bumpy. Pretty sure if you were to actually race an IndyCar on it, you would knock a few fillings loose. It had a lot less participation this week than normal. Only about 60 people entered the race. So we have two splits of about 30. I look to be in the second split, starting in car number two. Qualified in fifth place. Just a couple tenths ahead of me, a couple tenths behind me. Our pole sitter is on pole by a second and a half, so he's probably just going to take off and dominate the race. As for me, I just want to finish. It's been since Silverstone last season since I actually finished a race. The race after that was at Sonoma, punted someone going up into turn four. Then we had Watkins Glen, where I spun out at the toe of the boot. So here I'm gonna try to play it cool. Not push as hard as I can. Because if you're pushing at the very limit at Sebring, somewhere a bump is gonna catch you out and you're gonna end up spinning out. I'd like to avoid that. Keep that from happening. Could really use some solid points here. Not doing so great in the championship. Yeah, maybe, you know, and I picked fifth place as a goal. And that seemed to be more coming from a place of, you know, just in the few races I did last season, I did reasonably okay in the championship. So I figured if I'm competing in every single race, the top five should be cake. But maybe it is if I start finishing races. Seems like the people that are occupying the top five right now in my division are series regulars. So I'm going to have to start taking it to them. Start seeing the points I want to see. As for fuel strategy, I am expecting to use the better part of two entire tanks of fuel. So starting on max fuel, I'm going to stop for 17 and a half gallons, which gives me a pretty tight pit window. I'm not exactly sure what lap number that is. I have to figure it out based on how much fuel I have in the car. Aside from that, I hope this race is entertaining for you guys. I hope it is not extremely stress-inducing for me. I'm hoping to just get a solid finish here. If I could stay right here in fifth place, I would be extremely happy.
Get ready, going green.
Came to me. turn one appears to be my biggest weakness. Got swarmed on the opening lap, guy caught right up to me there on the second lap. Turn one's where I always play it super cool though, because I've just never been able to find the line through there.
Trying to avoid.
particular race that really helped me learn brakes was last season racing the GT3 around Monza. Particularly the first chicane. I was eating people up in the first chicane. Kind of surprised me. So I feel like in every other game I've ever played, the first chicane at Monza has always been what killed me. GT3 car, I'm just flying past people. Won that race easily. Started in third or fourth, and I was leading by lap 3 all the way. for me for another reason too. I appropriated the TV from the bedroom. I'm using that as my monitor for racing purposes. So it's great to have a giant picture right in front of me. Not too big. It's only a 32-inch TV, but the monitor was 21, but it's only a 30-hertz TV. That was just TJ that was spun out, so we got second place. Anyways, but it's only 30 hertz. I've had it for a really long time. Still LCD and everything, but refresh rate isn't what I wish it could be. And I also ordered a sim racing cockpit over the weekend. So I've just been doing these with a wheel sitting at my computer desk. After a sim racing cockpit for a number of years. Finally had the money to make it happen, so I'm very excited for that. Just gonna set up a card table over the top of it and put the TV on it. Need to find a better TV at some point to use as a monitor for racing purposes. Or just completely wait until the Rift comes out, the Oculus Rift. I have been planning on getting one of those. I was just reading that it's going to basically require an overhaul to my computer. It's going to require two USB 3.0 ports, and I don't have any of those on my rig. So if I have to replace the motherboard, I'm going to replace the motherboard, I might as well replace the processor as well. Car behind me, so looks like he's probably slowing up TJ instead of not TJ that far.
Still there, hold your line.
freaking lap traffic. Mode. screwed up now. On this in lap that I needed to not screw up. And I missed a shift. It's okay, TJ's faster than us anyways. We finish, that's fine. As long as we finish. Would have been nice to have that podium, but I threw it away myself. sucks the most about that spin is I saw it coming a mile away. There's nothing I can do to save it. At least I didn't do anything to save it. I didn't have the skill to save it. Same end result. Thank you. catch you up to me. Breaking on the grass there. You do not do that. Practice where I went to go hit the push to pass, but I accidentally pushed the pit speed limit. Not gonna find any speed with that button. Focused on keeping the car on track. That was just my best lap of the race. Finished fourth. Very happy with that.
The chicken flag. Great job. You did really well.
After having a number of really just awful road races, really pleased with that one. Probably could have finished on the podium had I not spun out on my in lap, but that's the way it goes sometimes. So that is it for Sebring. The Slipstream crew, we will be at Petit Le Mans this weekend. So that's going to be a lot of fun. I've never been to Road Atlanta before, never been to an endurance race that long before, so I'm very excited for that. And next week the race will be at Iowa, so keep a lookout for that as well. My videos this week might be a little bit delayed. Doing a lot of furniture reorganizing and stuff around the apartment, so it might take a little bit of extra time to get them up. But as always, thanks for watching, guys. See you next week at Iowa.